Hi there. Hey, I'm gonna jump on tonight and talk about how to do something that you don't feel ready for. Because this is a topic that comes up, especially this time of year, being January with all the new health resolutions and just resolutions in general, when we say things like, when I get here, I will do this. Like, when I get fit, I'll start going to the gym every day. Or when I have money, I'll start doing this. Or when I'm in this new job, I'll do this. Or when I'm in this relationship, I'll be happy, right? We do this a lot. We say, when I have this, I will be this. That's what I want to talk about tonight. So thanks for joining me. Hey, so you guys, I'm Natalie Jill. If you don't know me, I'm a licensed master sports nutritionist and functional fitness trainer, and I kill fat for a living. And fat as in FAT, not the fat on your body, fat that is false assumed truths that hold us back, especially with aging. I'm 47, for those of you that don't know, and I love talking to so many of you, but especially women in their 40s and 50s that have a story around aging, that feel that that is in their way, that it's holding them back. They think they're too old, it's too late, too whatever. I love talking right into that. And that's one of those topics I'm going to be addressing tonight. So if you're on tonight, let me know where you're joining me from. I'd love to know that. Hey, Jacqueline, I see you. Let me know where you're on from. And also let me know your age. I'd love to know your age. I want to know if I'm reaching women in my same age group, or if you're a lot younger or older, you're all welcome. But let me know so I know who I'm talking to and where you're from. And I'm on Facebook and on Instagram here, so my eyes might be going back a little back and forth. But thanks for joining me tonight. So I'm gonna dive right into it. So this happens, especially in January, where we start this story of when I get here, I will do this. And I see it all the time. And what happens is we start January with these great intentions, like I'm gonna lose all this weight this year, or I'm gonna find the love of my life, or I'm finally gonna start that business, or I'm gonna finally do this. We have this great grand goal, right? And then what happens is we start making a list of the actions that we need to take, and we start, and just even a few days in, something happens. What happens? Our comfort zone starts taking over, and we say, I'm a little uncomfortable. I don't like the way I feel at the gym right now. Or, wait, this is a little stretchy. I know I said I was gonna do that, but really, my finances, maybe I shouldn't do that. Or, I know I said I wanted a relationship, but I'm really not ready to date yet because I don't feel this. How many of you know that story? How many of you know it? Be honest. How many of you know that story where you talk yourself out of things because you say, when I get there, I will do this? And especially when it comes to working out, I know many of you have heard this before where you hear somebody say, well, just go to the gym anyway. You know, no one's looking at you. Even though you're feeling self-conscious, not good about yourself, someone says, just go anyway. Just go anyway. And it's hard to get out of your head with that. So I want to give you some actual actions that you can start implementing right now. So I'm going to give you some very simple things that will help you become that person you want to become and take action right now. Are you ready? And I'm going to not say just do it, because I know that sounds a lot easier than it actually is. So the first thing I want you to note is that your body does not know the difference between what it's thinking about and what it's actually doing. So this is where visualization comes into play. And I don't know if any of you have seen this movie. If you haven't seen it, it's a must-watch. Have you guys seen that movie with Amy Schumer? It's called I Feel Pretty. It's so good. If you haven't seen it, it's awesome. Definitely get it. But basically, she's this average woman, and she's feeling overweight and not attractive, and she has an accident. It's a comedy, by the way. She has an accident. She bumps her head, and she wakes up, and she thinks she's a supermodel. Like, she literally thinks she's a supermodel. And her entire life, her job, her friends, her career, her relationships, everything in her life changes because she now thinks she's a supermodel. Nothing changed. Nothing physically changed on her, but she thinks she's a fitness model, and her whole life starts changing because of a new belief that she has. Because to her, that's what she now became. That's what she was visualizing. It actually happened, but that's what she became. And her body, everything started reacting to that. So the first thing that you can do is literally visualize, put yourself in the mindset of the person that's already there. And to share with you, and this is an old picture, but I love pulling it out and showing you. This is me 11 years ago, okay? So 11 years ago, I just had my daughter. That's me. And by the way, I'm 5'2", you guys. I'm 5'2". I had gained 60 pounds more than I am now. So, and I guess I was pregnant, so I'm owning that. I was definitely pregnant right here. And I just had her. She's out now. So she's now 11, by the way. She doesn't like when I show this picture now. But I gained 60 pounds, and that was flat out from eating McDonald's french fries and chocolate sundaes with extra fudge and not working out and not being happy in my life. I had a lot of stuff going on in my life. This was back 2008, 2009, when the stock market had crashed. Everything had changed. Stock market had crashed, real estate had crashed. I found myself going through a divorce, a newly single mom, totally depressed, no finances, just really feeling stuck, really feeling stuck. And I remember looking at this girl in the mirror going, I don't even know what it feels like to be fit or happy or healthy or excited about my day. I couldn't even get past what I looked like. And I just thought, I can't even relate to those people that are fit, happy, and healthy, and in a great relationship and making money. I couldn't even relate to it. So let me tell you what I did. Number one is, because I had that story of when I get there, I'll start. Like when my finances clear up, I'll take action. Or when I lose the weight, I'll take the action. Or when I meet a person, whatever. I had this whole story around when I meet them, I'll do this. So what did I do? I made a vision board. It's the number one first step that I took. I made a vision board, and I put on there people that were healthy, fit, happy. I put a beach on there. I put a golf course. I put whatever made me feel good. And I would stare at that vision board every single day. And I thought, okay, I don't feel like the person on this vision board right now, but what would it feel like to be that person? And I would just stare at this board like, okay, this fit girl there, what would it feel like to be her? What would that look like? What would it feel like? What would I be eating? How would I be spending my time? And I would really get into the idea of like, who is that person on that board and what would she be thinking? Because you all, we can be an entirely different person a year from now by changing our thoughts and actions. That's it. By changing your thoughts, everything you think about, and changing the actions you take, you become an entirely different person. And I knew that this girl right here did not have the right thoughts happening, and she was definitely not taking the right actions. So I had to change those thoughts and actions. So I put all these pictures of what I visualized that I could become. Now, here's the key when you do a vision board. You cannot get caught up in the how or why it's not gonna work. If you do that, you stop the fantasizing. So you have to literally just pull out things that are going to inspire you, that are gonna motivate you. When I made that first vision board, I had no idea that I wanted to do anything that I do today. I wasn't doing anything in fitness at the time. And I put girls on magazine covers. I put all kinds of things, fit girls. And let me tell you guys, I'm 47 right now. I'm 47. I made that first vision board at age 36. And I put fit girls on magazine covers. Had I known that this was gonna be me last year, I mean, really? That? I would have never known that. But on my vision board, I had fit girls. Did I know that I was gonna be on the cover of Women's World, like helping others lose weight? I had no idea. But I put people on that vision board that motivated and inspired me. And I would look at that board and go, okay, I don't feel this in my body now, but if I can look at that and stare at this and envision what it would be like to living at that life, then I can start to shift and change. So that's step number one. That's what I did. I created a vision for what it is that I actually wanted. And if I ask many of you, like, what's your vision? You might say, I don't know. So I'm going to tell you that is a great place to start. Like, go make a vision board. Start with pulling out pictures. Reflect on what is it you actually want to feel and be, and start looking at that. And that's the first step on starting to take some action. The next thing, make choices that that person on that vision board would make. So if that's your future self, if that's who you want to step into and become, why are you making choices from where you are right now today? I got it that that person right now doesn't feel fit and doesn't feel ready to go to the gym or work out. What is that person in the vision board doing? What would those choices be? I got it that the person right now that you are feels that she can't afford something, that she doesn't have the money to do it. What would the person that's going to become, that you're going to become, you're going to step into, what decision would that person make? Where would she invest in herself? Where would she spend money? Where would she make decisions from? Start having those thoughts and actions from that person. And that's who you step into. You can be an entirely different person. I can't say this enough. You can be an entirely different person a year from now than you are right now today by changing your thoughts and actions. It's so simple, but I get it feels hard. But it's really as simple as that. You change your thoughts, you change your actions, you become an entirely different person, period. It's impossible not to. So you make choices from that person you want to become. What would that person do? I would tell the same person that advice in business. If you own a business and you're stuck and you're making choices from the scarcity or where you are now, then you're not dreaming big. You're not stepping into where you want to go. Somebody who's smart in business makes choices from where they want to go. They hire for where they're going, not where they are. They hire for where they're going, not from where they are right now. So make those choices. Invest in yourself the way that person would. The next thing is take those actions from that person. What would that person be physically doing? So when I had that vision board and I had fit girls on there, I had a beach view. I remember I had an ocean view and I loved that ocean view, and I was living in a house that didn't have an ocean view at the time, and I definitely wasn't fit. But I thought, if I lived in a house that had an ocean view, what actions would I be taking every day? And I said, well, when I have that ocean view home, I would be walking on the beach every day, right? Sounds great. And I would do that. When I have this, I would do this. So what did I do? I started taking actions as that person. I drove to the beach. I would drive there every day, and I would go walk on the beach. Who cares? I didn't physically live there, but I still embodied that same experience. I still had that experience of walking on the beach every day. So I became that person. I took those actions as that person. So I hope that supports you. I hope that helps you. So, and if you're just jumping on now and you missed the beginning, I'm gonna leave this up so you'll be able to go back and rewatch. But you wanna, you know, when you are having those thoughts of when I get there, I will do this, I'm gonna challenge you, I'm gonna interrupt that conversation to start acting as if right now. Like, look at that visualization of who do you want to step into and start taking actions like that person would. I hope that that helps you tonight. I hope that that helps you. Hey guys, two things I wanna share with you really quick. My number one favorite thing to do, is get together with small groups of you, like not just be on video. Like I'm talking to you on Instagram and Facebook Live, and that's fun and all, but I'm looking at myself right now. Like I see myself and I see your comments and your questions. What I love to do is actually interact with you as a small group. That's my favorite thing to do. And my favorite thing to do every year is my breakthrough weekends. And I did 3 last year and I'm doing 2 this year. So I've got 20 spots total for 2 breakthrough weekends. And I'm sharing this with you right now because if you're at all interested, I'm gonna tell you how to apply. I want you to apply because everything I just spoke into, like super laser quick, I just on Energizer Bunny speed, we spend 3 days like going deep on this stuff and we individualize it for you. So like if you're sitting here with me, we go deep on this and we figure out what your vision is, what your purpose is, and we help you create a plan moving forward that's fail-proof and it sticks. So not only do we work out and eat together and have all kinds of fun and experiences together, but we go deep on your vision and what's holding you back and help you break through that so that you can take those actions and start changing your thoughts and your actions. So if you are at all interested in applying, please do. We have 20 spots total, and I'm just gonna be real with you. We have how many, Brooks? Like 55 applications right now for 20 spots. We've already accepted in 5, so we have 15 spots left. So if you're at all interested, if this message is landing with you and you want support getting that to stick and really taking this year to another level, like breaking through those stories of why things haven't worked for you, breaking through those stories of not creating and having in your life what you want, if you want support with that, please apply. And I'm on Facebook right here. I'm going to type in the link. It's Natalie, natalie.jillfitness.com/apply. And if someone's on Instagram and wants to type it, I can pin it. But it's natalie.jillfitness.com/apply. You just fill out an application. We're taking a look at all of those and we're going to be selecting, and we may actually even call you direct and have a little session with you and talk to you about if it's a good opportunity for you. So definitely would love to see you on that. And if you found this live helpful, please share it, comment, and let me know that you want more, and I will be doing a lot more for you. All right. Thanks, you guys. Have a good night. Bye.